Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Laurel Woods, the We360 Entrepreneur Program Manager. Welcome to the Why Women Started Up Pitch Competition, brought to you by YWCA Houston and the Macquarie Group. Today, we embark on an exciting journey into the realm of entrepreneurship with a special focus on uplifting and guiding women of color on their entrepreneurial ventures. Our program's purpose is clear: to provide steadfast support and guidance to women of color as they navigate the complex landscape of entrepreneurship. Here, we're not just building businesses, we're nurturing dreams and aspirations. To achieve this mission, we've outlined key steps that act as a roadmap for success. Our 12-week virtual program begins with a solid foundation, crafting a comprehensive business plan, essentially a blueprint that transforms grand ideas into tangible reality. We then walk alongside our entrepreneurs, helping them establish their businesses. Securing business banking is a crucial milestone in our journey, ensuring financial stability and growth. And finally, the moment we eagerly anticipate, launching these remarkable businesses into the world. Upon completing and graduating from the program, our participants have the opportunity to pitch their businesses for a grant. Not only is the grant financial support, it's a vote of confidence in the vision and potential of these entrepreneurs. So sit tight for an afternoon filled with inspiration, innovation, and celebration of entrepreneurship. Now, a word from our CEO, Terry Broussard Davis.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Terry Broussard Davis, CEO of YWCA Houston, an organization deeply committed to a mission that resonates at the core of our values. At the heart of our organization lies a simple yet powerful mission to empower, uplift, and support women. I want to share a concise overview of what drives us, what fuels our passion every single day. At YWCA Houston, we believe in not just breaking barriers, but shattering them. Our mission extends beyond mere empowerment. It's about creating avenues for success, especially for women of color. We are dedicated to providing the tools, resources, and guidance necessary for them to not only enter, but thrive in their chosen market. As we gather here virtually, remember that our goal is not just about the individual success of these incredible entrepreneurs, but about fostering a community of support and collaboration. It's about ensuring that no woman feels alone on her journey, and that every step forward is a victory for all of us. So let's this afternoon be a celebration of resilience, ambition, and the boundless potential within each woman. As we witness the pitches and victories, let us reaffirm our commitment to helping women of color succeed, not just today, but in every endeavor endeavor they undertake. Thank you for being a part of this empowering mission. Together, we create a future where success knows no boundaries. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Terry. It is my honor to introduce the esteemed panel of judges. We have Tiffany Burrell, Development Manager for Young Women's Preparatory Network. She has served in executive leadership, program management, and fund development in the social services and education arena for over 20 years, focusing on empowering girls through education, rebuilding communities, and activating the potential in every young person. In her role as development manager, Tiffany currently supports campuses in Houston ISD and Aldine ISD, where she is committed to connecting people to resources and resources to sustainable programming that supports girls and young women in the greater Houston area. Tiffany has been married to her college sweetheart, Charles Burrell, since 1995. Tiffany is the proud mother of Xavier and Jasmine, who both graduated from Houston ISD Single Gender Academies. Our second judge is Nicole Spohr, Managing Director at Macquarie Group and the head of its Commodities and Global Markets Regulatory Compliance Team. She has 25 plus years of legal and regulatory experience with significant expertise in commodity and financial markets. She serves on Macquarie's Racial Equity Fund Committee and is co-chair of Macquarie's Unity Employee Network Group. Nicole is passionate about her community and engaged with numerous nonprofits. She is an Impact 100 Houston founding member and current president of the Raise Up Families Board of Directors. Our third judge is Dr. Leslie Woodard, project manager for NASA Office of STEM Engagement. She manages five NASA activities, including the Minority University Research and Education Project, as well as the Innovation and Tech Transfer Idea Competition. Dr. Woodard's vision is for all races and genders to share equally in the economic prosperity of our country by prioritizing racial and gender equity, building transformational partnerships, and exposing inclusive audiences to research and best practice in the field of STEM education. When she is not working, Dr. Woodard is swimming, traveling with her friends and the Golden Girls, and spending time with her 11-year-old daughter, Dallas, and 3-year-old Yorkie, Blue. Judges, we thank you for volunteering your time to join us today in supporting these five amazing women. Without further delay, let's dive into the heart of We 360 and witness the beautiful stories that will unfold. Shannon Callahan, Director of National Programs at YWCA USA, will now introduce our five finalists.
All right, well, good afternoon and welcome. As Laurel said, I'm Shannon Callahan. I'm the National Program Director at YWCA USA. I have the honor and privilege of introducing our finalists this afternoon. But before we get started, I wanted to provide an overview of the pitch format and share with you what you can expect this afternoon. Each of the five finalists have 3 minutes to present and pitch, after which the judges will have 5 minutes for questions and answers. So in total, each pitch may last about 8 minutes. So then after all finalists complete their pitches, our three judges will go to a private virtual space to deliberate and choose the top three pitches to be awarded cash prizes. And so the first place prize will be $15,000. The second place prize is $10,000. And the third place prize is $5,000. Our cash prizes are made possible through our partnership with the Macquarie Group. So a big thank you to the Macquarie Group for their generous support. So now what you've actually all been waiting for, and without further ado, I'm excited to introduce our first finalist. So please meet Ayesha Oduteyo. She is a Houstonian, an educator, an author, and a philanthropist. She holds a master's degree in educational leadership, works for the Houston Independent School District, and has published 3 children's books. Additionally, Ayesha is very active in her community. She's a member of Alpha Kappa Alpha, Top Ladies of Distinction, and the Association of Texas Professional Educators, to name a few. Combining her event planning and educational leadership skills with her passion for community and providing resources to those that are underserved, she started OKO Management 310 to work with organizations foundations, celebrities, and nonprofits to create impactful events. So please join me in welcoming Aisha to the stage. You are welcome to get started.
Classes in session. I'm Professor Aisha Odetayo, and I want to teach you how businesses can grow their brand through brand activation through community events. Who is AKO Management? AKO Management 310 is a proprietorship founded by myself, Aisha Odetayo. I have 20 years' experience of event planning, community engagement, and brand activation. I have worked with popular businesses, brands, including Exotic Pop, She's Happy Hair, James Harden Foundation, and C-STEM. What is AKO? What does AKO Management do? Community event planning for businesses, helping connect the businesses to communities, set up events in communities to help with brand awareness, providing trainings for businesses to help with community relations. When do businesses need to contact AKO Management 310? When businesses want to grow their brand and help increase their sales by building relationships with consumers, communities, through hands-on experiences, and to plan their events, because I will plan your event from start to finish. Think of me when Easter time comes, think of me when Thanksgiving, back to school, and any time that your business is in need. Where can you find AKO Management Services? Well, glad that you asked. Consultation and planning with businesses are available via Zoom, Teams, and in person. My services are available global and locally. I plan events from start to finish, set up events, and do brand activations in communities and areas to bring awareness to businesses. Glad to hear it. Because building relationships with communities can help brand awareness and show consumers and others that your business is socially responsible, and it can help increase the customer relationships and retention and loyalty, and you can stand out against your competition. How can you get in touch with AKO Management? By word of mouth. How I can be contacted is through email, phone call. How much are my services? Prices are based on your project and based on the number of hours that it takes to for your service and your for your service, and depending on the project detail. So with that being said, let AKO Management take your business to the next level to avoid recession. So again, community is what connects us all. Thank you.
Thank you, Aisha. All right, so judges, you now have 5 minutes to ask questions if you want to go ahead and get started.
Excellent. Thank you so much. That was really a great pitch, and congratulations on being one of the finalists. My first question is kind of, what is your target market? Is it across all types of entities, or do you have any kind of more targeted market in mind?
So my target is businesses that want to grow their brand. So businesses that are starting off, businesses that are already established. So I come in, I do the event consultant, the event consultation, I also do the planning for them. I know a lot of times in the world, we see businesses out in the community with brand activation, but what they're lacking is the community engagement. And that's where I come in. I help with the relationships. I go out in the community and see where the needs are to help that business grow.
Excellent. Thank you. So I'll go ahead and ask a follow-up while I think one of the other judges was coming on. Can you give us an example of one of the types of events or how it rolls out?
So I'm glad you asked that. So with She's Happy Hair, what I do is I do their community event consulting. So what I do is I go, I help with the planning of the event. So we'll go out like For instance, we have our Christmas event coming up. So She's Happy Hair is a Black-owned hair company. And so I go and I set the event up. I go, I help pass out the flyers. I help promote the event. We provide the resources for the community. And so making sure that they have, you know, what they need to make sure that She's Happy Hair is branded and showing that they're giving back to the community. And so with that being said, that's going to help their business and help people want to patronize because they see that they're socially responsible by giving back to the community.
I have a question. So how does that leveraging work? So you mentioned community engagement events, and then you mentioned driving their business. What do you do to connect that? How are you that bridge?
So as I mentioned, when you did my introduction that I work in the community, I also work for the school district. So basically, I find out where the needs are. A lot of times businesses are disconnected because they're so caught up in the work and they don't really have that relationship with the community. So I go out and I build that relationship. I go out, I set up the events, I find out what the needs are. If there's like an Easter event coming up, I say, hey, let's go ahead. This will be a great opportunity for you to market your company and your brand. So let's go out and let's plan an event where we invite the community out and we advertise your business. We promote it on the radio and we, you know, we just go out and we just plan the event. So I come in, I connect them because they're not connected to the community. A lot of times, as we see, you don't get to see the CEO, you don't get to see the VP, and they don't really know how to build that relationship with the community. So that's where I come in. I have 20 years experience with communities, building that relationship, and I'm the boots to the ground for the businesses.
I have a question. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
So in a market that may be saturated, what sets you apart from everyone else? What makes you different?
Okay, what sets me apart is that I have 20 years experience. I'm connected to the community. As I mentioned earlier, I've been boots to the ground for the last 20 years. I know where the needs are. I know where businesses can you know, put their money in and ensure that quality, that they have quality for what they're getting. What sets me apart is that I'm passionate about what I do. Another thing that sets me apart is that I'm a go-getter. I'm connected. I'm just that person that just loves the community and making sure that we have those resources that can help everybody in the community.
And what's the largest event you've ever hosted?
The largest event I've ever hosted was one with C-STEM, which we had like 1,000 people. Actually, I would say with She's Happy Hair, we had 1,500 people in the park. We had so many people that they're not inviting us back this year. And we gave out free t-shirts. Everybody's walking around with the She's Happy Hair t-shirts. So that's one of the largest events that I hosted. We gave out free food, free Easter eggs, and we had the Easter Bunny out there. So that would be my largest event with 1,500 people.
Okay, well, thank you. Thank you to the judges. Thank you to Aisha for answering all those questions. And we are going to move on to our next finalist. So it is my pleasure to introduce Desiree Thomas. She is a 34-year-old dynamo hailing from Port Arthur, Texas, and shaped by the vibrant community of Beaumont. With a decade-long commitment to the United States Postal Service, Desiree has cultivated both professional stability and an entrepreneurial spirit. In 2018, she took a leap into the world of celebrations, establishing her own venture, Such a Sweet Touch Events. Desiree's creative prowess shines through in her versatile event planning and decor business. She specializes in balloon artistry, table centerpieces, and orchestrating memorable private and corporate events. She aspires to transition fully into entrepreneurship by expanding her business to include uplifting and empowering opportunities to boost young girls' self-esteem. Please join me in welcoming Desiree to the stage. All right.
Hello.
All right, you are good to go.
Step into a whimsical haven designed exclusively for girls aged 3 to 13. Picture this, a magical bus adorned in shades of pink where imagination knows no bounds. As the door swings open, young minds are invited to embark on a journey where pampering and play converges. Imagine a space where little ones don fluffy pink robes, walk the runway of a pink carpet, and indulge in a realm of beauty and self-expression. Let the wheels of imagination turn as we transform every session into an unforgettable adventure for the princesses in your life. My name is Desiree, and I present to you Sweetie Pie's Spa Bus. In today's fast-paced world, convenience is key. We eliminate the need for parents to drive miles for kids' pampering sessions and entertainment. With non-toxic products, we prioritize the health of your little ones, offering manicures, pedicures, makeup, dress-up, and karaoke, all within the comfort of our specially designed bus. What sets us apart? Unlike brick-and-mortar locations, we are not bound to a building. With a service in a 100-mile radius from Beaumont, Texas, we will arrive at your front door. Our personalized approach fosters unity amongst girls, building self-confidence, and encouraging healthy stress coping mechanisms. With 10,687 birthdays every day in the United States, the ever-evolving event industry, and a surge of mobile businesses since 2020, provides us with a vast market to tap into. Let's face it, celebrations are here to stay. Our marketing strategy is as dynamic as our services, leveraging social media, radio advertisement, local event participation, and the bus itself is moving promotion. As we grow, our long-term vision involves expansion with multiple buses across various locations, catering to females of all age groups. The funds we seek will be allocated to purchasing the bus, starting renovations, and purchasing necessary items to run the bus. Our team comprises of myself, a decorator and wedding and event planner who holds a Class B commercial license, a licensed nurse, a vibrant teen who volunteers with the youth, a licensed cosmetologist, and esthetician. In conclusion, our kids' mobile spa bus isn't just a business, it's a movement. It's about making a positive impact on our children's well-being, promoting relaxation, and creating lasting memories. Join us on this journey as we roll out convenience, fun, and confidence to your Sweetie Pie, one mobile spa session at a time. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Desiree. All right, so judges, you are back up and you are welcome to start asking questions. I think Matt will put you all up there. Great.
Excellent. Thank you, Desiree. That was great to hear, and congratulations on being a finalist. As you talked about how we've moved toward this mobile parties and, since 2020, and how did you test the market and determine that your business model, could survive against other competitors?
So where I am located, there's not much for kids to do. As I've done my research, and in contacting the individuals who would renovate the bus, he informed me on how profitable this business has become in the area in which he lives. I rented one of these buses for my daughter when she was 5. She still talks about it to this day, and she is 13. So by me being mobile and able to go to you, and you're not having to drive to us, it's convenient for you. It saves time. I'm competitive with prices because I don't have that much overhead.
And could you walk me through the experience of your party bus, how people book you, what those rates look like, and who is your target market? Like what types of families are you doing business with right now?
I will be doing businesses with parents with little girls. So my starting rate would be $425. That would be on Friday and Saturday. On Sunday, I would drop the rate to $375. There would be considered a peak season from about May to August, where we could literally work Sunday through Saturday. And then our off season would be when school would start, because 9 times out of 10, we would only get guests for the weekend. We can pretty much, with a 30-minute commute in the Golden Triangle, we can probably accommodate about 8 parties a day. And that would take care of that. I did mention before, I do have a very soft spot for single mothers because I am one myself. And so I do plan to every month be able to provide a free service to a mother in need that would love to do something special for their daughter. And that way word of mouth will come into play. I have a family member that works for the radio station. He would be willing to help in that aspect. By me already having a business, I do have a fan base, as you could call it. And so I believe I would have the support to thrive in that with this business.
But just to clarify, have you launched this business yet?
No, this is an idea. Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
And maybe along those lines, so you mentioned you have somebody set up, like, from whom to purchase the bus or remodel the bus for this purpose. Can you walk us through kind of what is your timeline for getting it off the ground?
If I could get it off today, I would. But I would at least give myself 6 months to a year to get everything situated.
Thank you.
Good afternoon. I love the fact that you mentioned stats when you kind of discussed the market. I heard you mention that you don't have any overhead, but you had a team of a nurse, a decorator, cosmetologist, so on and so forth. Can you go into that a little bit further?
As far as why would I select those individuals to be a part of the team?
No, you mentioned that you did not have overhead. So I just wanted to kind of find out what you meant by overhead, since you have this team.
Yes, ma'am. So what I meant by as not as much overhead as if I was in a building, I would have rent, I would have bills, I would have, you know, those things I wouldn't have to necessarily focus on by it being a mobile business. It's a pretty much one-time investment, except for when items need to be repurchased or possible maintenance on the bus. But that's what I meant in reference to not much overhead.
Okay. Thank you so much, judges, for your questions, and Desiree for being here and pitching your idea. So we are going to move on to the next finalist. So it is, let's see, where are we? Sorry about that. Well, for some reason, it doesn't want to take me off video, which is fine. There we are. Okay. So it's my pleasure to introduce Melody Blackwood. She is the founder of Juvie Leadership Wellness Center. Melody brings a diverse background, including a mechanical engineering degree, IBM training experience, and leadership roles in biotech. With a mission to empower educational leaders, Melody's expertise spans curriculum implementation, team collaboration, and fostering high-performing schools. As a certified principal in Texas, her innovative approach at JUVLWC aims to elevate leadership, instructional system, and team well-being. Melody, a wife, mother of 3, and grandmother of 1, is dedicated to shaping a positive future for education. Please join me in welcoming Melody to the stage. Melody, the floor is yours.
Thank you. I want you to think back to that one teacher, that one leader, or that mentor who shaped your life. The one who saw you for who you were, your genius, honored it, or even met a need. Now, I want you to hold that person in your mind. And then I want you to now think about if they were completely erased from your memory. Where would you be today without their guidance? And so the education field has faced a significant loss of teachers and leaders. Over 300,000 have exited the field between the years 2020 and 2022. And I just want you to think about, according to the Labor Bureau and statistics, why do you think are those top three reasons for them leaving at alarming rates? If you chose, my friends, low compensation, burnout, and lack of resources, my friend, you are correct. Juve LWC, we serve as a sounding board for leaders as they navigate these educational challenges, including things such as staff retention and limited resources. We partner with schools from adding capacity as instructional coaches to building an empathetic lens of those decision makers by using focus groups and or case studies. This year, we have broadened our impact by partnering with Full Mind Learning to provide innovative solutions such as virtual staffing of qualified educators across the nation. And so far, we've worked with over 25 partners across the state of Texas and over 100 nationwide. Our 1 acre ranch, located in the heart of Ocala, Texas, it offers a space for team building, envisioning, and rest, because we are aiming to create a haven for rejuvenation and growth. And our plans to expand with the money we hope to win here today include some of our projects like the Meditation Center, adding access for people with varying abilities, as well as creating a larger leadership structure for gatherings. Our goal is to utilize the academic year, this academic year, to host leadership retreats as early as January 2024. And additional funding will allow us to put the final touches on the property so that we can start to pilot these programs and gather the feedback to improve our future partner experience. As we establish our retreat, we aim to distinguish ourselves because we're providing that tranquil setting for team building and leadership development. Juve LWC, we are embodying the potential of creating a space where leaders can thrive and nurture the next generation. So join us. Join us in extending this vision and impact, because I aim to make that teacher for me, Miss Irvin, so, so proud for listening to the needs of her people, because I talked the entire fourth grade year and she held me accountable. I am Melody Blackwood, the proud owner of Juve LWC, where leaders are developed and rejuvenated.
Thank you, Melody. All right, so we are next up with the judges who will be starting asking you questions any minute. I'm gonna let them come to the stage, as you will.
First of all, congratulations on being a finalist. Thank you for your presentation. I guess my starting question is just to make sure I clearly understand, in terms of your target market, is it education providers?
Yes.
So it's leadership focused, leadership yes. skills for people provided in the education sector.
Yes. Okay. But that's actually a really good question, because some of the things that I do also is I give back to the community. So I also work with high school students for leadership camps and things of that nature. So even though the primary income source is through this educational partnership, I still do other community things where I do leadership building.
Okay, fantastic. Because it sounds like your business has been up and running for some time now, and you continue to focus on how you can grow it. So I'm curious to know if you're also focused on expanding your market. Like, will you continue to be focused on that industry sector, or are you looking at other potential, you know, non-education related sectors?
Yes, absolutely. So to be clear, I have been doing education consulting. This is my fifth year. I did it originally under a company, and I built that company from three people to over 30 people now working in Texas, or right, maybe 20 now working at Texas, inside of the state of Texas. Since then, I've separated and started my own education consulting and partnered with Full Mind for the virtual staffing. Right now I'm in the phase of, I just acquired the 1 acre property and I'm trying to renovate it, and I'm going to get data using my educational partnerships to build out that system. And then I will expand it once I've gotten it right.
Okay, great. Thank you.
No problem.
I have a question. I know that you have the 1 acre property. How are you going to navigate the market of everyone wanting to be online?
That's a good question. Well, I got to start small. I would love to expand and acquire more properties, and I don't necessarily have to use mine as the physical space because the programming is what's bringing. So if I need to partner to extend it with other hotels or other recreational places, like I've done with the Mademoiselle, the organization I'm a part of, we've done a retreat with the high school students. I think it was like 8 to 9 years before we stopped last year. And that is back in LaGrange, Texas. So I can always partner with them to host retreats there too. So the spacing is just the one place that I have to get it right, but I can expand it wherever there's a place.
No. How do you navigate the market of, you know, people preferring to be online as opposed to being in person?
Yes. So I offer virtual online staff development as well. But that's my focus for building and getting this money is to really plan out the space if people want to come in person. But I actually do virtual coaching, supporting, and leadership team building right now as we speak. I actually did one today, to be honest.
Thank you.
No problem.
Could you share with us a little bit about if somebody came to you and they said, hey, I'd like to, you know, hold a leadership offsite for my team, what would that look like for them?
So I like to go inside of the systems, talk to them and get some feedback around why do you want this? Like, what is the reasoning for this? Get their vision around it, study their team. And then after I get a time to just get all of the data that I need through my intake questionnaires and my meetings with them, I then develop a plan alongside of them. I will not come before their people until they've had a chance to look at that plan, co-collaborate with me. And then if there's a case where I can add or build capacity, I'll say, hey, if you have some leaders, I'd love for them to be a part of us actually executing on this. And I'll actually train their leaders to do this work so that they don't always have to depend on me.
So are your services more bespoke and tailored to the leadership needs, or do you have kind of a menu of
I start with something, but then I'm not opposed to customizing it to meet the need. Yes.
Okay. Thank you so much to the judges and to Melody. And I apologize, we had a little technical snafu with the other judge, but we are working on that. Okay, so it is my pleasure to introduce our next finalist. And there we go. For some reason, my camera doesn't want to go off, but again, it's okay because you're not here to see me. It's my pleasure to introduce Dr. Raquel Grogan-Webb, who goes by Dr. Rocky. She is a board-certified chiropractor in Katy, Texas. She has a master's of science in nutrition and human performance. Her experiences as a collegiate soccer player and mother have influenced her passion and beliefs. Dr. Rocky specializes in nutrition, prenatal, athletic, and pediatric care. She enjoys family time and staying active through soccer, running, and kickboxing. Dr. Rocky is committed to helping patients achieve optimal nutritional success with personalized plans. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Rocky to the stage. Dr. Rocky, welcome, and you are free to start.
Well, hello, I'm Dr. Raquel Grogan-Webb, or Dr. Rocky, as my patients fondly call me. I'm a wife, a proud mother of four, and a passionate founder of Health Inspired Chiropractic, a venture dedicated to the holistic betterment of young athletes. As a former college athlete, nutritionist, and experienced chiropractor, I'm here to share with you my passion to nurture the next generation of champions, both on the field and in life. Consider this. In the U.S., a disturbing 17% of children between the ages of 10 and 17 are grappling with obesity. Meanwhile, over half of our nation's youth are actively engaging in sports, striving to be their best. Yet a shocking one-third of all injuries in children are sports-related, underscoring a critical gap in preventative care and performance optimization, while only a mere 3% have ever consulted a chiropractor. Throughout my time as a student athlete, my ability to reach my full potential was hindered by challenges such as knee pain, persistent headaches, and less than optimal diet that did not support my performance goals. I've experienced firsthand the gaps within our existing healthcare system. My own athletic endeavors were tarnished by discomfort, nutritional inadequacies, hindrances that should never impede a young individual whose potential knows no bounds. Despite the clear need, resources for these aspiring sports stars are scarce, especially in my local area. Most clinics cater to adult athletes or those chasing aesthetic goals, leaving our youth without the tailored support they require. What sets us apart is our 6-week interactive Strong Healthy Kids course, which is meticulously tailored to each child. It's an avenue not just for recovery, but for preventative and performance enhancement. And once the 6-week transformative weeks are over, the journey doesn't end. We offer ongoing support to ensure that these young athletes continue to thrive and maintain momentum and reach the next level of success. The course covers crucial areas in nutrition, injury prevention, and empowering the young athletes to take control of their health through various activities and education. So far, our clinic has thrived through word of mouth, partnerships with coaches, and organic social media reach. But to extend our impact, we're embracing a strategic expansion by investing in professional marketing and enhancing our online presence. We aim to nurture our clinic's growth. This will pave the way to hire more staff like doctors and more receptionists. Imagine a future where preventative injuries are a rarity and young athletes are equipped with the knowledge and skills to make healthier choices both on and off the field. Join forces with us at Health Inspired Chiropractic, where your child just isn't another athlete, though the next sports prodigy in the making. Together, let's bid farewell to preventative injuries and unhealthy habits and welcome a new era of stronger, healthier young champions.
Thank you, Dr. Rocky. All right, now I'm going to invite the judges to come back and ask you some questions.
Hello.
Hello.
Great job. You mentioned you wanted to invest in professional marketing. What type of marketing are you looking for, and have you priced out?
Yes, I have priced out. They range between like $500 to $700, just depending on what you looking for. I would like a marketer that specifically markets with chiropractors, just for the simple fact that chiropractic is such a passionate field because we're hands-on, right? So I would like to have a chiropractic marketer for that. And then also a social media person that will deal more with the nutrition part of my business, because nutrition, even though it is it is a passionate portion and it is hands-on, I can do that online. So I don't need to have someone that's local to do that. Someone that is anywhere can do that part of my business for the marketing aspect.
Your target audience, you said kids. What ages are you looking at?
So kids athletes, they start from about 5 years old all the way till 17 or 18, if you consider the high school seniors. So that would be the target market, but each program would be different. A 5-year-old would not get the same type of program that a 17-year-old would be. A 17-year-old would have more of a hands-on approach. They would be in charge of their own health and their own care with the guidance of me and learning the steps that they need to make sure that they're able to better their abilities on the field and also have better nutrition once they leave the household and they're in college. A younger kid would get the steps that I would give to the parents that they would not only implement with them, but also the family as a whole, so that the kid doesn't feel like they're being left out or sidelined and everybody else is eating something else and they have to eat one thing or another. So I wanna just make, it has to be tailored per age just to see what's going on in their life and their families to make sure everybody is successful in this, because that's the main part. You wanna have a sustainable plan. If it's not sustainable, there's no reason to even start.
Thank you. Hi, I have a question about your fee schedule and responsible parties. So who is paying for these services and how are you billing?
So I bill for this whole 6 weeks. The parents are responsible for paying. I do either payment plans, which is four smaller payments, or you could pay it all at once. If you pay it all at once, you get a 20% discount off of the whole thing. If you do a payment plan, it's a little bit more expensive, but sometimes it fits people's bank accounts better. And then once they're finished with the 6 weeks, there's a smaller fee that's added on for each session that they are seen after that.
Dr. Rocky. Thank you for being here. It was great to hear your pitch and congratulations on being a finalist. I guess one question I have to start is this is an existing business already. This is.
Yes. I already see kids and have parents that come to see me for example, I have a kid that was trying to lose weight for football. He was O lineman. He was a junior high student. And I, even though the parent is in the room when I teach, I focus on the kid because they have to understand just as much as the parents on what's going on and what they're doing. But within the 6 weeks, he was able to lose 20 pounds towards his goal weight. And when he came back to me, he was so proud because he was the only offensive lineman in the seventh grade that was able to finish the workout where everybody else was tired and sluggish. He was like, I had so much energy, Dr. Rocky. And that's what I live for. That's what I want to see.
Oh, that's fantastic. So I understand the program is 6 weeks, but it does sound like it's very much tailored depending on the age of the child, their sports, their needs. Could you, and I think what you just gave us was a bit of an example of that. So I think, you know, I'm coming at it, I'm a mom of a 10-year-old competitive soccer player, you know, so what does it look like? Can you kind of break it down for us? Someone comes in, what does that 6 weeks look like in terms of time commitment, what they take away from it, you know, just okay. Kind of
yeah, makes
how
sense.
You create the program.
Okay. So the first one is all about consultation. So I just want to see where the kid is at, what's going on, ask the parents some questions, ask them some questions, what their goal is, and see, is this something that you want to do? Or is it like your parents want to do it? What's going on? And then after that, we talk about their muscles and their joints and what they're doing, because I want to make sure that they know how to keep their body aligned while they're playing these sports to help prevent injuries. And then we talk about nutrition, and that's what macronutrients are and what micronutrients are, and help them build food, meal plans for themselves, and then also help them see what's going on and track what they're eating and see how each item fits in, or each item feels in their body when they're eating it. If they're eating something and it makes them feel sluggish or sick the next day, we're going to backtrack off of that kind of item and stay away from there. And then also I teach them how to do a grocery list and look on a food label and see what's going on in the food label. I'm sorry
to do that. I hate to have to do this, but I do have to.
No, it's okay.
But thank you so much for being here. And thank you again to the judges for being here as well. And I'm going to go ahead and move us on and introduce our final pitch of the afternoon. So it is my pleasure to introduce Kay Jackson. Kay is a visionary in the realm of media and the creative force behind Real Film School. Armed with a bachelor's degree in media production from the American Intercontinental University, Kay has seamlessly blended her corporate experience, her passion for filmmaking, and her commitment to education by creating an all-inclusive filmmaking program. The program provides an in-depth perspective into the film industry for minority youth to launch successful careers in the dynamic world of film. Kay is a multifaceted individual with a zest for life and believes that every dream is within reach within the right mindset. So please join me in welcoming Kay to the stage. Okay, you are all set and ready to go when you are.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Consider this harsh truth. Removing arts programs from schools sets a troubling course for our children. In areas without arts, we not only see high school dropouts, but also a decline in college pursuits and a rise in violent crimes. Shockingly, Georgia ranks 43rd among states grappling with this issue. Although there's a diminishing support for arts education, the world of film is flourishing in Georgia, offering a beacon of hope for our youth. Hi, my name is Kay Jackson, accomplished filmmaker and founder of Real Film School. Real Film School is an innovative, unparalleled, and comprehensive skill development program designed to empower high school juniors and seniors with the skills necessary to launch successful careers in the dynamic and competitive world of film. Throughout my career, I noticed that over 90% of my peers did not have sustainable careers in the industry. And a recent survey shows that more than 85% of film school graduates will never find steady work. At Real Film School, our program is a lifeline for our future, a chance for them to discover their passions and chart their own destinies. In a world where dropout rates plague our communities, we see Real Film School as a beacon of hope, a pathway for students to escape their harsh environments and find purpose through the art of filmmaking, like I did. We've examined why film schools consistently fall short, especially in regards to the alarming rate of displaced graduates. At Real Film School, we have the potential to offer the most advanced and innovative curriculum in the country, implementing real change. Here's how. We've pioneered a modular program, empowering students to customize their experience. Unlike competitors, we've abandoned outdated film overview courses for a real, modern approach to filmmaking. Our courses provide comprehensive insights, delving deep into subjects, and our specialty courses, led by industry experts, give graduates a competitive edge for real-world employment. Currently, zero schools in Georgia offer courses on color grading or aerial videography, for example, which would equip our graduates with the tools that makes the difference in a successful film career. Real Film School provides a competitive edge with affordable options, full program enrollment, standalone course purchase, or choose from three subscription plans for tutorials, ebooks, post-production tools, and more. Completion of any of our courses earns student certificates from our certified instructors. We'll offer one-on-one coaching and feedback to all of our enrollees. With your investment, we can train our first set of instructors to carry out our mission as we continue engaging with local high schools to decrease dropout rates and increase student engagement. Our long-term goal is to expand our reach and establishment to empower more youth in the real film world. So why just send them to film school when you can send them to Real Film School? Thank you.
Thank you, Kay. All right, I'm going to invite the judges back to the stage. So if you can join us by taking yourself off, putting yourself back on video, that would be great. And as soon as you're all here, you can start asking questions and the timer will begin when you're all here. Great.
I have a quick question about your how it impacts graduation and high school retention. Can you give me some stats behind that with some of the students that you've worked with?
Yeah, so right now we're starting out. This is just all a start, an idea that we plan to implement. However, I did study some of those rates that you asked about. So the over 85% of like displaced graduates or those who will never find work, that's coming from the IATSE's motion picture industry branch. It covers everybody from actors to producers to cinematographers, the whole house. So.
Hi, Kay. So how are you? Is this an online program or are you going to these schools to work with the juniors and seniors?
So we have this online, but as well as in school. So the plan is to actually really go in schools as a physical program for high school juniors and seniors. And those who are not able to access it through that way, I have like an online segment, or I would like to implement an online segment that you can go in and sign up for a monthly membership. And there you're able to access us for like tutorials and like I said, the post-production tools and webinars, we're going to host those kind of things, master classes, forearms, things like that.
And I noticed that you said you had industry experts. So are you setting up some type of pipeline for your students after they graduate or finish your program?
Yes, ma'am. Absolutely. We want to be a segue right into the, like I said, the real film world, because so far, all of us are graduates from film. And it's like I said, we're all displaced in a sense, especially like with the strike and things like that. What sets people apart are like the credit hours that they put in with local guilds and stuff like that. Since we already have experts experienced in that and none of the schools teach that, we're going to implement that into our program. And so any type of short film that our students work on, we're working with the guilds to get that stuff credited. So when they come out of there, they'll probably have more credits than I would, at this point, and I've been in this career now for, 8 years? So, yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
So, congrats, Kay, on being a finalist. I guess in terms of just making sure I'm clear on kind of your audience, is your goal that you're only focused on high school students and you're going to partner with schools or provide services that kids can access? Or are you looking for a broader audience, you know, both high school students as well as post high school?
Yes, I really want to implement it with high school because that's where my heart is. It's always kind of been there. I feel like those are the most important years for you to like navigate your life. You know, you're kind of figuring out at that point. So I really, really want to implement it physically there. However, I do want to have an online segment so that anybody can access it. You know what I mean? Like, I really want to push it for like other students who are not able to. So say I start this in Georgia, how do I reach the kids who are not in Georgia? You know, there's a pipeline in Houston. That's kind of like a third, you know, space right now for film. So I want to increase this the best way that I can.
And does that mean that you're going to partner with the schools themselves to provide programming that happens during the school day? Or are you looking at providing like after school, like in partnership, but like after school programming?
That's a great question. Right now, my team, they're actually working right now with the schools to try to figure out us getting into the schools during the day. However, if we're not able to, I'm definitely comfortable with doing an after school program or even a summer school. So we're right there right now. Those are our options, but priority is getting in the schools. We want to kind of get it during the day.
And you just mentioned your team. Can you talk a little bit about what that team of people looks like? You know, is this you? Do you have staff or do you have partners in this?
Yes, ma'am. Right now we have partners. So I have an multi-award winning director, film director, and he can cover everything from top to bottom with film. So that's definitely one of my right hands. Also have Donnell Gamage. He is a certified Unreal specialist. And Unreal is like a game engine, but they just incorporated that into the film world about a year ago. So this is something that is also a necessity for me that helps. He's certified in that. We also now just added 2 aerial videography people to the team. They're both whole FAAs.
I'm sorry to do this, but I have to cut you off. Yeah. But I think you were able to get in most of your answer there. All right, well, thank you, Kay, and thank you to the judges. So we have had all 5 of our finalists pitch, which is very exciting. So thank you for that. And the judges now will go to their secret virtual place to negotiate and decide on our final 3 winners. And so right now I'm going to pass it back to Laurel to continue the rest of the programming for us.
Thank you, Shannon. Those were some amazing pitches. So just as Shannon said, the judges will step away to deliberate. In the meantime, let's keep the energy alive. I'm excited to bring you another highlight of our afternoon, a guest speaker whose insights are bound to empower us. Elaine Gonzalez-Johnson is the founder of Latinas in Motion. Her inspiring and captivating speech at our Women's Empowerment Summit left such an impact that we'll be treating you to a video excerpt. In this clip, Elaine empowers us by reminding us that we are one of one and that success starts with you and is found in the little things. Get ready to be inspired by Elaine Gonzalez-Johnson.
And so I decided I was going to go speak. So let me tell you about my first speaking engagement. I wore a little string of pearls. I wore what I thought a speaker would look like. I didn't go as me. I went representative of what someone who I thought would be respected would look like. The speech was horrible. I said 1,000 times. My slideshow had about 40 slides. I was running through my words. And I felt so uncomfortable because I felt like I was pretending to be somebody. And the lesson that I learned is that I will always win if I go as me. Every single thing that I need to be the person that I have been designed to be the person I have been created to be, is already within me. The problem is that I was so busy looking to the left and to the right, and what does a successful person look like? And what does somebody who speaks well look like? When at the end of the day, I'm the source, right? They want to hear my story. And so instead of going as someone else, I decided anytime someone invites me, I'm going to tell my story my way. I'm going to say John if I want to say John, right? I'm going to wear my gold hoops. I'm going to wear my red lipstick. I'm going to go as me. And if I'm supposed to be in that room, I will be accepted. And if they say, thank you. And if they say, whoever they is, say, then that's not my room. There is no opportunity. If it's for you, I pinky promise it will not pass you. And if a door closed, it wasn't your door. We have allowed pop culture and social media to put limits on ourselves. We have allowed pop culture and social media to tell us what we're supposed to look like, what is the beauty standard, how much money we're supposed to make, what kind of car we're supposed to drive. If you don't decide what success is for you, not for your mom, not for your kids, not for your homies in the group chat, what is success for you? You have to write that down. Make a list. I made a list. I knew I would be successful when I would be able to take my children to school. That's success for me. I will be successful when I get to date my husband once a week minimum. That's success for me. And if opportunities don't align with my list of success, with my list of non-negotiables, then it's not the opportunity for me. Do not go out there chasing your idea of what people tell you success is, that you lose yourself and you lose your family and you lose your fire and you lose your purpose. There is no one on this planet Earth like you. That's to make you walk a little different. That's to make you talk a little different. You're the sauce. If nobody told you today, you are that girl. You really are. You really are. And so as I started speaking, one of the questions I would get every time, if I got this question, I pinky promise your girl would probably be a millionaire by today. And it was, how do you start your day? You have such great energy. How do you start your day? And so I decided I'm gonna give y'all the keys. Okay. All right, we ready. So the first thing is practice gratitude. Any book you've ever read, whether it be Oprah, Lisa Nichols, Tony Robbins, everyone is always going to say this in one shape or form: practice gratitude. There's research. Anxiety and gratitude cannot live in your brain at the same time. Do you hear me? I don't know about you, but after this pandemic, your girl been real anxious. After this pandemic, little things be overwhelming me, right? We live through some real stuff. Anxiety and gratitude cannot live in your brain at the same time. When you open up your eyes in the morning, instead of grabbing your phone and checking your email, instead of turning on the TV and checking the news, literally, if you don't write it down, say it out loud. What are you grateful for? And no matter how hard life is, I pinky promise there is always something to be grateful for. You woke up, grateful. You got a roof over your head, grateful. You got water to drink, grateful. I know you see the news of what's going on. You're here today, grateful. Change your mindset, change your life. We can't be out here running businesses when our spirits are not together. You want to be out here chasing the bag? Baby, chase your purpose. Chase peace. And I promise you, everything else will come after that. Change your mindset, change your life. Affirmations. What you say out your mouth, your mind believes it as it is so. What you say out your mouth, your mind believes it as it is so. So if you say you great, you really are. If you call your mom in the morning, I call my mom. I love my mom, y'all. I am a mommy's girl. Call my mom. Elaine, how you doing? Mom, today I feel real fat today. What am I affirming? Because y'all gonna sit here and be like, I don't affirm. You said it out your mouth. Your mind believes it as it is so. Mom, I feel real tired on today. Stop affirming that over your life. Stop affirming that over your life. You tired? You still got something in you. You don't feel like you're your best self? Make the decision to change it. You have the power to decide. You, spoiler alert, baby, you make the rules. A lot of us in this room have had really hard cards dealt to us, me included. You still got purpose. You still got opportunity. I don't care how old you are, how young you are, what family you came from, what opportunities you have, what degrees, did you drop out of school? Did you graduate from school? You're here in this room, that's destiny. You're here in this room, that's opportunity. You're here in this room, it's for a reason. Don't you dare leave these doors without getting what you came here for. Everywhere that I go, there's, listen, opportunity, purpose, destiny in that room. And I'm not leaving until I get what I came here for. Do the same. There are brilliant ideas in this room. Your mentor may be in this room. Your mentee may be in this room. Your funder may be in this room. Or maybe the person that's just supposed to connect you to the next person is in this room. Don't you dare leave this room with your little notebook, having had not talked to somebody that you didn't come here with. You got to get outside of yourself. This isn't about me. This isn't about me. This is about you, making sure that you leave here walking in the excellence that you have been created with. Affirm that. My daughter's 13, my son is 9. We recite affirmations every single day since they could talk. If they were here right now and you'd be like, Eva, give me an affirmation, she's gonna say, I'm powerful. If you ask my son Ian, he's gonna say, I'm a magnet for good things. 13 and 9. Why? We do that every day. My kids are Puerto Rican and Black. The world is going to tell them what they are, what they're not. One thing they're going to learn at home from their parents is who we say they are. And you're no different. You're no different. Affirmations. You want to know what the game changer is? Affirm yourself. Start with gratitude. Life will change. This is strategy. These are things that you're putting in your toolbox, but they only work if you work it. If you leave here today and wake up in the morning tomorrow, grab your phone, don't say what you're grateful for, don't recite affirmations, do not be mad next year when your life looks the same. I don't know who neck I'm stepping on. I'm not even gonna look at nobody. I ain't even gonna look at nobody. I don't want to put nobody on the spot. This is one of the best lessons that I learned. There's so much power in the pivot. What does that mean? As women, I'm going to tell on myself. I won't tell on you. We get so attached and married to an idea that we had. If I said I was going to be a teacher, even if I hate teaching, I told everybody so. I'm not gonna tell everybody that I hate it. If I told everybody I was gonna sell perfume and I cannot stand perfume 10 years later, well, I can't not sell perfume because I already told everybody. You have the right to change your mind. Free yourself from that. There is power in the pivot. If you tried something and you don't wanna do it anymore, stop. You wanna know what's the best lesson I learned is that I don't have as much time as I think I have. And if I don't wake up every day loving my life, the only life that your girl got, then what are we doing? What are we doing? You want to know how many times I changed my mind? And I'll change it again. The only thing I'm married to is the Lord, my husband, and them kids. Everything else, nope, don't want to do that no more. And I do that with pride. And it irritates people because my light shines so bright. And I decide what's what, that people who are so attached and they don't understand, they don't know, like, so you just changed your mind? And I did. I opened a brick and mortar with a partner in 2015. When we had to renew our lease, decided I don't want to do this anymore. Closed it. It was a great lesson, right? It's like, free yourself. I went to school. I got my real estate license. Then decided, you know what? Don't want to do this anymore. Stop doing it. I don't understand as women why we get, oh, I changed my mind. That's beautiful. But you want to know what's crazy? When we see celebrities change their mind, we give them an applause. But then we come at our sisters like, girl, you gonna change your mind again? You want to know how many? Beyonce started a clothing line, ended. Then she started Ivy Park. That partnership is going to come to an end. She dropped a perfume in 2010. Years later, she's about to. They do it all the time. But then we look at Beyonce and be like, that's Beyonce, alien superstar. Right? But the girl on the block that's your friend that changed her mind is just like, she doesn't know what she wants to do in life. Why do we do that to each other? There's power in the pivot. Instead of looking at it as, man, I had to change my mind again. It's a pivot, baby. Listen, your girl's Puerto Rican. When you dance salsa, there is power in that pivot, okay? I know y'all know. Free yourself. When you leave here, I want you to leave here designing the life of your dreams without limit. Whoever clipped your wings, get those wings back. Whoever told you you couldn't, that was their perception. That was their own insecurity. You actually can. You actually can. One of my biggest pet peeves is when people say, I'm gonna try. So I wake up every day, 5 days a week, I won't say every day, 5 days a week. I wake up at 5:15 and I work out on my Peloton, right? My husband's still asleep, looking all good and restful. My kids asleep and I go all the way downstairs and I work out. And so I post it, right? I'm a poster, Instagram, Facebook, I'll post it. And people will say, you're so inspiring. I'm gonna try to do that tomorrow. And I write back, you lied, right? I'm gonna try to do that. No, you lied. You decide. You wanna wake up at 5:15 with me, baby? Okay, set that alarm. It's a decision. I decide, I value my health, so I'm going to drink water. I decide I want to spend time with my kids, so I'm taking them to school every day. You have the power to design the life of your dreams. Whoever told you you couldn't, they lie. Stop looking at social media, reality TV, scrolling on Instagram, letting your life pass you by. Write it down. Create the plan. Work the plan. Listen, I already told you I'm a church girl. Even the Bible says, write the vision, make it plain. I'm not telling you anything new. I'm packaging it a little bit different so that when you walk out of here today, you're walking in the fullness of your excellence. And you're walking out of here with the tools and the equipment you need to have things change. Because success, it's not in the big things. It's in the little things. Opportunities chase me down. Why? Because I've committed to the little things. Because I have integrity with the little things. Because who I am on social media is the same exact person I am in real life. You're no different. You have so much greatness inside of you. If you think you don't, you do. Let me be the first person to tell you. Whatever idea you have in this room, you came here for some answers. Don't you dare leave without getting those answers. And keep working it. Keep working your plan. Start your day with gratitude. affirm yourself. Do not be afraid to pivot if you have to. And don't ever forget, you're one of one. You are one of one. So if you guys want to stay connected with me, I have my website, email, and my Instagram. I'm definitely an Instagram lover, but we actually have some time for Q&A. So get your questions together. You want to sit with me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Let's sit.
Thank
Let's
you,
chat.
Elaine. Yes. So we are going to get questions from the audience, but I have a couple myself. So I may or may not follow you on Instagram. But I really want to know, who gave you permission to be audacious?
Ooh, that is a good question. You ain't tell me you was going to start with the fire. Who gave me permission? I think I got tired of making excuses as to why everyone else's life was so great and why I felt so mediocre. I would look around and feel like, she got it going on and they're so happy and they're this. Then I decided, I'm excellent. I'm great. Why not me? So maybe it started with a question of like, why not me? And then I just started going after every single thing I felt had my name on it. And some of it worked out and some of it didn't. But I feel like there were lessons in all of it.
Nice, nice. So you really talked about, one, to go as yourself.
Yes.
Two, prioritizing yourself. But you also talked about, I'm a wife, I'm a mother, I'm a business owner, I post on social media, I have national partnerships, I go to speaking engagements, as we all are, we do all the things.
Right.
So how do you prioritize you, prioritize self, prioritize taking care of everyone else in you and self-care, when the reality of it is there's no time?
It's true. I will say this. Everything has a bucket. You know how most people will be like, it's about balance. They lied. They definitely lied. It's not about balance. It's about prioritizing what's what, right? So if, you know, I have a speaking engagement in Houston, then I already know tag team and my husband, babe, you gotta take these kids to school, right? And my husband is an incredible human being. He's a principal, he has his doctorate, right? But it's about communication. So one, I will tell you, although I stand here by myself, I have an entire incredible village behind me that makes sure they support whatever it is that I'm doing or we're doing as a family unit. But I would say put everything in buckets. Non-negotiable for me is definitely working out my health. Why? It's not just about Latinas in motion. It's when I'm healthy and when I feel like I'm my best self, everyone benefits from that. So when I'm healthy and when I'm my best self, then I could be a great wife. I could be a great mother. I could excel at work. I can be a great daughter. But when I'm not filling in that bucket, when I put me last, everything falls apart. Every single thing falls apart. I'm snippy. I feel like I'm all over the place. So non-negotiable is definitely myself. And honestly, my family. When I am disconnected from my husband, my kids, they are definitely the foundation of who I am. Because at the end of the day, your work is always going to be there. Your work is always going to be there. But what life are you creating for yourself? Could you imagine having millions of dollars and being alone? Then what was the point? What was the point, right? And so you have to make sure that as you design the life that you want, you're prioritizing the things that bring you joy, and decide that for yourself. But definitely working out, making sure that I'm good. I've gotten to a place where I write in my planner, do not disturb. So like there are some Sundays where I say no to everybody, and I'm a recovering people pleaser. So it was really hard for me to create those boundaries because I didn't want you to be upset with me. So if you invited me to dinner, even though I have not had 1 hour to myself because I don't want you to be upset or because I don't want to offend you, I would say yes to you and no to myself. Then when I started realizing all of the no's to myself are stacking up and I'm bitter and I'm resentful and I'm snippy and I don't even know who I am when I look in the mirror, what was the point to that? So remember, every yes you give to somebody is a no you're giving to yourself. So even if you have to write it down in a planner on your phone, do not disturb. It's a me day, it's a you day. And you know what? For all the parents here, I used to feel mom guilt. Like, how can I just take a day off from mothering? Now I'm like, because I can, because I deserve it. And I'm teaching my daughter and my son how to prioritize their well-being as well. So instead of feeling guilty about it, now I'm teaching them tools when they grow up, they have to prioritize themselves as well. That makes sense?
So I have another question too, because you talked about, I'm gonna leave my notes alone. Full disclosure, I love Elaine. I've probably known her about, I don't know, 20 years. But anyway, you know, you talked about your support system, right? And you talked about gratitude, and it is a blessing and an honor to have that support system. But what about your sister out here who is building her business?
Yes.
They don't have the benefit of really having a support system. How are they navigating that piece? How do they find time for self? And how do they identify their piece of success?
Yes, great question. I will say, build the table. What does that mean? When I first started Latinas in Motion, no one in my family joined, not even my mom. She is a member today. My mom is a member today. But sometimes when you're the first to create something, people don't believe it. They may not believe you. They may not believe what you're creating. They don't want to purchase. And we get offended. Like, how could you not buy my candle? How could you not support my nonprofit? When at the end of the day, when I say create your table, I literally had to create what I call my kitchen table. Yes, I did steal that from Michelle Obama and Oprah. It was theirs first. But I created my kitchen table of my village of women who not only cover me, but have my back. They don't steal my ideas. I didn't even get to talk to y'all about that, but everybody does not need to know your next business venture until you have it crafted out, LLC, trademarked and protected, because people out here will be stealing your ideas. But make sure, I had to give that to y'all like the Spark Notes version, but make sure that you have created a village of people that you feel safe with, that you feel seen with, that you can be authentically who you are. My kitchen table of friends, they are educators, they're business owners. One person has a nonprofit, but it is my space that when I feel like life gets really hard or when I feel like I can't, because even though I'm here in the fullness of who I am, best believe there have been times where I said, I can't do this. I don't want to do this anymore. Maybe I'm not equipped. And those are the same women that say, actually, you can. You better suit it up, wear that lipstick because you were called to this. Because sometimes you're at the bottom and you don't know how to get up. And if you think you could do it by yourself, you need people. You need a village. I am a firm believer that success is directly connected to people. And so make sure that you're building that table. What does that require of you? It requires you to get outside of yourself. It requires you, all those people you grandfather into your life, thinking like they're going to be a part of my table. Some of them can't have a seat at that table because they just don't get it. It doesn't mean that they're bad people. It just means put them in a different seat on a different table. But when it comes down to your business, you need to build that solid table of people who are going to cover you, see you, honor you, and make sure that when you feel like you can't, they're like, actually, you can.
Thank you. So I'm going to get one more question. I'm gonna go back to my trusty dusty notepad. But again, I may or may not follow you. And so yesterday I saw that you wrote, you know, my goal has always been whole life success. Peace, love, joy, and purpose is the real bag. You mm-hmm. talked a lot about the bag today. So what would you suggest to the entrepreneur who is struggling to identify their purpose?
Oh, that's so good. If you're struggling to identify your purpose, I will say that start with you, spend some time alone, turn the noise down. And for me, if I'm being completely honest, I have tons of conversations with my creator. He created me. So what should I do next? I don't know what your life is, who you honor, but for me, my relationship with God, my faith, one of one, right? But also making sure that you serve your way. The more you serve, the more you spend time with yourself, the more you know you, the better you are to everyone around you. There's no greater gift than being sure of yourself. And it took me a really long time to figure that out, because for a long time, I wanted to be who people wanted me to be. I wanted to be the picture of success. I wanted to be whatever people.
All right. It looks like our judges are done deliberating. So Ms. Terry, are you ready to announce the winners?
Yes, I am. Oh, okay. They want me to start my video. Okay. And I'm so excited for everyone. First, I just want to say congratulations to every entrepreneur, because you are a winner yourself, period. Our third place winner is Jay Jackson, Real Film School. Congratulations, Jay. Kay Jackson. Yes, congratulations, Kay. Second place goes to Dr. Rocky. Dr. Rocky, congratulations. And our first place winner is Desiree Thomas. Desiree, congratulations. And congratulations to all of our finalists and our three winners.
Congratulations, ladies, and congratulations, everyone.
Yes, congratulations.
Congratulations, everybody.
Oh, my goodness. Oh. I don't want to wipe my eyes because my lashes and makeup is going to come off. Thank y'all so much. Okay. I'm okay.
It's okay. We understand. We'd all feel the same way.
Oh my goodness. Thank you all so, so much. Oh my goodness. I don't even know what to say.
That's all right. You have your moment. I'll speak for you.
Okay. All right.
Congratulations, Desiree, on your taking first place. And congratulations, everyone. On behalf of the staff at YWCA Houston, we are so proud of all of you for your hard work, and we will continue to support you and uplift you on your journeys. A special thank you to the McCreary Group for partnering with us and providing valuable tools and resources for our entrepreneurs. And thank you to our audience for joining us this afternoon. This is what it's all about, everyone coming together and supporting and empowering one another. So this may be the end of the pitch competition, but it's the start of great opportunities to come soon for our We360 program. If you are a woman of color looking to start a business or add structure to your business, please visit our website at ywcahouston.org to learn more about our entrepreneurship program and how to apply for the next cohort. Thank you all again, and have a great rest of your day.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, guys.